Hello everyone, it is Francesco here. I hope you're all doing very well. In today's video, what I thought I'd do is a tour of my Notion account. It's been a fair while since I actually did a video about this. I'm going to be doing a workflow video soon to show you all of the apps in the sort of ecosystem that I use, but in today's video, I thought I'd focus in on Notion. Now, before we begin, I'm actually going to be toning down on my Notion videos. I don't think I'm doing as much of them just because I want to explore a few more applications in the market. And naturally, I've been doing Notion videos for like closing in on 3 years now, which is pretty long time, even for one application to focus in on. Maybe I'm getting a little bit of Notion fatigue. I don't know. But you may see a lack of videos of Notion coming out. But oh well, don't worry, it'll be okay. So as you can imagine, I've been using Notion since maybe 3 years now, it's a total, and I've really enjoyed the experience, and I've had a fair few changes in the last few months. So maybe I'll show you around my account and then explore that, what those changes have been. Hopefully this will help. So obviously this is my workspace, but in this case I made a copy to blank out some information. Obviously I want to make sure to include everything that I do inside of the account. Now, I actually use two accounts now. I was actually for quite a long period of time connecting the Keep Productive workspace into my own workspace. However, I've definitely found in the last couple of months that keeping them separate is quite good. So that's been fairly recent, but I have a separate workspace, which I'll talk about nearer the end. So as you can see here, it's really simple. I actually have gone pretty lazy on it, although I should probably need to just make these headings. So as you can see here, I have some core sort of routine ones that I go into, values, projects, and health. So let's start with values. So this is actually something that I've started to put together with the help of Chris Stancy. It's more of like a sort of list of things that I'd like to strive towards each day with different aspects of my life. I'm definitely looking into this more about how to do it better. But as you can see here, I've started trying backlink, but I want to sort of try and grow this a little bit more and make this a bit more of a sort of crib sheet for sort of my main focuses. So I guess when I'm working on a new project, I can look into this and go, okay, does this align with my values? The second thing is a project area. As you can see here, I've been doing for the majority of the year a project per month, but I'm more moved into quarters now in order to relieve a little bit pressure for me, because I tend to have found projects just moved around quite a lot. And you can see here that I'm using the board view. There is the ability to use timeline view. Maybe I'm not sort of taking advantage of it yet, but now I'm sort of keeping sort of 2 to 3 projects per month to sort of work on. So I'll just take this one, for example, July 2020. Once it loads, you can see there, these were much more granular projects, but I want to sort of do a little bit bigger projects over a larger period of time. So I have an area called health. This is fairly recent as well. As you can see here, I've sort of set a goal at the top. And what I'm doing is now logging my boxing workouts and what I could do better on them. So if I go into this, it's normally like what I did and what I could actually do to improve it when I'm going outside and doing that. So that's pulled in from my notes, which I'll talk about in a bit. But the notes have been quite a good place to actually just organize and plan out. I've also started this habits area as well, a little popper toggle for some stretches, exercises that I might want to do at my desk. But I've also started this habits area to try and keep some good quality habits going. For example, like plank for 1 minute, you know, small things that I can do across my day that I can probably help improve my day-to-day lifestyle. And I'm going with a check score at the bottom so I can actually see like, okay, how much have I checked so far? So I've got a house one as well. We're like eventually going to aim to get a new house, a bit of a bigger one so that I can have a separate room for an office and it's not the baby's room. But you can see here that I've got a few tasks on each of them, like, for example, things that we can do inside of this house, things that saving, sort of broken it down into, like, I guess, 5 steps. But this is quite nice because if an evening we want to like write down a few things that we want to do, then we can start ticking them off on this list. So I've also got one for payments. This is more to do with work. I probably should probably put this in Keep Productive's area. However, I found that obviously I don't necessarily want to share what's coming up in payments with other people in the group. So I might want to just keep this one internal now. So I normally put like the amount that's due, and then the vendor and the type of it and whether it's been paid. And then I can sort of chase up what I need to when I need to. So in terms of notes, I've been using notes a little bit more than often, everything from tracking weaning notes all the way to calls and things like that that are starting. But I've also been doing like not meditations, but like exercise with sort of expressive journalism. Where is it journaling, where I can like sort of talk through anything during my day, like what I'm worrying about and things like that, everything around sort of work. So I'm sort of like constantly adding stuff to this, which is quite nice. This is just alphabetical order. I normally see it in the card view, but as you can see, it's sort of really nice way I can save stuff. It doesn't really have any rules to it actually, but I took a lot of value and notes from the Tiago Forte video. So this is something I actually haven't used yet. I'm asking for a Kindle for Christmas from my wife and her family. And if I get it, if Santa's good to me, then I will probably connect it with Readwise to help me start reading some books. So that should be really nice. Finances has been something that I've been using for quite a while now inside of Notion. I really like this layout here. It's quite simple, but what I do here is I put the account over on this left-hand side, the bank it's associated to, who owns the account, and an outline of what the account is about. And I start adding the amounts in here. Then I can sort of make notes if I'm on this left-hand side. So for example, with the mortgage repayments, I make a note whenever I call them and pay a little bit more off if I can. Then any reference stuff appears here, which is helpful, for example, for connecting other pages or notes that might be useful. So we've also got an expenses area. So every couple of months, we then dive into this and actually update how much stuff costs monthly. And what we do is then see what the yearly cost is. And that's simply just times it by 12 and also by 6. And we can see down here that this is our monthly or our yearly expenses going out. So obviously I've removed a few things, but that's how we can sort of judge how much we're spending. And we also put occasional notes along this left-hand side to show, for example, is there anything that we can improve on? I also use the taxes area, and this is really to like keep updated with what tax I'm paying and payments that we pay in regularly, which is quite helpful. So this taxation area is pretty decent. And I also have a health area, which if I have a problem, then I write it down. And it's probably especially very useful now. But if I, for example, felt a bit ill a certain day, I might write it down here and give a sort of result of what that's about. So I've also started this area called people. I would say I was quite happy about this when I started using it, but over time, I would say it became a lot less useful. I'm not sure why, but maybe that's still sort of going. But as you can see here, I've got sort of key areas that I'm connected pages with people, and you can see the backlinks and what they're all connected to. So for example, with Becca, you've got all this stuff here and how they're connected up. Another example here with Otto, as you can see, these are some of the notes from my notebook. So all in all, that's how I use my Notion. It's really basic. That's probably why I'm not doing many videos anymore, because it's not as exciting as many other people's, but it really does help. Like I find a lot of value from using the Notion as more of a static bay for my information and also planning, which is super helpful. I've also got this, which is the Keep Productive area. And as you can see, we plan videos, articles. You can see how we plan articles, how we plan videos using this lovely board. And now that we are working with an editor, which is amazing, Steve, it's going to be fun to be able to sort that out. We've also got areas here for like affiliates and sponsors and public pages. But as you can see, the sort of theme with my sort of Notion accounts is reduction in complexity. One of the things that I started out doing when I had a Notion account, probably too much, was creating too much complexity and some really stupidly attractive areas. And I think that's naturally the culture, but definitely seeming to move away from that now. I think my time is much more limited than it was. So I'm probably spending better time inside of these applications. So as you can imagine, when I last did a tour, I was actually using Notion as my week planner for work. I wanted to separate Todoist with this, but I've actually come back full circle, and I think Boards has fixed that problem for me at making that sort of base on, inside of Todoist again. So as I said previously, I was using the week planner, maybe used it for about 2 months solid. As you can see, I'm using it very basically. I've got a backlog, a focus, and learning. So these are sort of core aspects of the day. The backlog is like what I need to do or need to look at. Focus is what I'm doing now, as you can see, recording, and also some learning that I would like to do during the day. I really want to try and make learning more of a part of my day, so I've put it there to sort of force me to check it out and clear it every day. And the good thing as well, if you notice there, I am not even putting any due dates on them. And that's mainly so that they don't avoid or damage the today area, which is full of my sort of main plans for the day. As you can see, highest priority has been. Why is Otto, Walk with Otto, so low priority? But I think it's because the bins are due tomorrow. And if I don't get them done, then, you know, that's going to be bad. So sometimes it is okay to move other applications, but at the same time, I think I was already inside of Notion. I had to trial it. In those 3 months, I didn't get on. I was doing well with it, but didn't get on with it as much as I did with Todoist Boards. And I'm glad to be back with that applications. And the way that I describe it is the way that Gabrielle Brazil describes it, who we've done a video here on the channel with. She describes it as her Notion is her static planning area, and Todoist is sort of the virtual assistant. And I definitely think that's the case in this situation as well. Anyway, folks, a big thank you. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you wanna check out the Notion course, you can check that out below. But again, I'm sorry if I'm not doing as many Notion videos, but I'm excited to be exploring other applications as we launch 2021. I do need a little bit of a break this year, I think, near the end of the year. Just to sort of relax and just take a breather. So hopefully that'll be nice. Anyway, folks, I'm really excited this start of the end of the year. We're going to be doing some exciting project that hopefully gets a few people involved from the community. I want to make this more community focused again. I think I've lost a lot of sort of the sort of exciting community conversations that we miss with the Facebook group. So I'd like to bring that back, and hopefully we do that in future content and the plans that we have with the community. Anyway, folks, a big thank you. I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.